Let's now talk to infectious diseases expert, Dr. Edson Salvagna. Good morning, Dr. Salvagna. Thank you, as always, for joining us.
Yeah, good morning. Good morning to everyone who's watching and listening.
All right, Dr. Edsel, first off, the weekly COVID-19 positivity rate and NCR, we know, has spiked to 25.4 as of May 13, but that's according to Okta research. What could be the explanations behind this?
Yeah, I don't understand why people are still talking about positivity rate. We heard naman the PHAP, and also actually even Yusek Verhere has said that positivity rate is no longer a good measure for our COVID cases because, as PHAP has said, we're only testing symptomatic. So there's a lot of bias. Mm-hmm. And the most important metric is still yung healthcare utilization rate, which we know is low.
Mm-hmm. And so it's not time to strengthen COVID measures and rising cases. How would you recommend going about this if we should be?
Yeah, I think we've been in a pandemic for more than 3 years. And if you look at the way that it's gone, I mean, the last week we had 12,000 cases, more than 12,000 cases for the last 2 weeks, but we had zero deaths. So this means that people already know how to protect themselves. The vaccines are continuing to protect even against the new variants. People wear masks when they feel like their risk is higher. So, you know, this is what we call endemicity. And, you know, we're there. That's what we were driving towards. Nobody wants to keep these restrictions on forever. And even WHO has said that the public health emergency is at an end. And what that means is, even though COVID is still here, we know how to manage it. And as long as we can keep the hospitals open and there's no threat to our healthcare system, it's going to be okay.
And so, Dr. Edsel, if the NCR's current COVID positivity rate isn't a cause for concern, what's a good metric that we should be looking at when it comes to deciding about our COVID situation and looking at it, how it's doing?
Yeah, so the best metrics are still healthcare utilization and, of course, the number of severe cases, because number of severe cases are the ones that will take up the hospital beds. And if we look at last week, we had 54 severe cases out of more than 12,000 cases, and that's a 0.43% of cases. Compare that to the start of the pandemic, where especially for the vulnerable population, up to 10% of those could die, and about 20% of those were severe. So, ang laki-laki na nung pagbabago. So, you know, the positivity rate, people aren't testing anymore or they're using antigen. That's a completely useless metric at this point, and it's really only just alarmist. So, I would urge people to really just look at what the hospitals, if the hospitals are full or not, how many are severe. Of course, continue to take care of your health. If you're in the vulnerable population when cases are high, it's a good idea to keep the masks, not just for COVID, but also for influenza, for other respiratory diseases. But in general, you know, we're living with this now, so I think it's okay.
All right, that's good to know, doctor. But tell us about the new strain, Arcturus. What makes it different from the other strains? Does that make any difference in how we deal with it? Is it any cause for concern?
I don't think so. I mean, the last genome sequencing showed that there were 3 additional cases. So it's not taking over. That's not what's pushing the thing. And even in those countries where they've seen a lot of Arcturus, which I really hate that name, by the way, it's called XBB.1.16. Arcturus is a made-up name. It's not even scientific. But the bottom line is, the vaccines are continuing to protect against severe disease. And as long as we have that, then there's no threat to our healthcare system. We can continue to live our lives.
Mm-hmm. And then how can we strike a balance between still being cautious, and then we have WHO saying that COVID has already stopped being a global health emergency?
Yeah, I mean, we've been living with the rules, with the mandates for the last 3 years. And I think we've already learned how to manage this. So we're shifting the burden of protection from the government to the individual. And I think after 3 years, if you've gotten vaccinated, you know when to wear a mask, especially in crowded conditions. If you're at risk, you can increase your protection. I think we're okay. Yung itong mga naririnig natin ng mga positivity rates and everything, that's noise. theories. It's not scientific. OIC DOH Secretary Verreria said it's useless. Dr. John Wong, who's the founder of Epimetrics and who's our epidemiologist at the DOH, has said it's useless. Dr. Ron Jean Solante, who is the Philippine College of Physicians president and is an adult infectious disease, has said it's useless. Dr. Anna Ong Lim, one of my fellow TAG members, it's useless. Bakit tayo nakikinig sa mga taong wala namang expertise? So I think that we have to stop this, playing it up and everything, because all the authorities, all the legitimate experts have already said it is not a good metric and it's just being alarmist.
Mm-hmm. And then following all this, what's your view on the mask mandate being reconsidered for some areas?
Yeah, I think, again, we've seen no deaths for the last, actually, the whole May so far, walang namamatay of COVID. And I think that people already know. There are people who keep wearing masks. I'm wearing a mask. I'm in my car right now. I think people have learned how to use it judiciously. Kind of like a seatbelt when you're in your car. You don't expect to get into an accident naman. But, if there's a lot of people, if there are those kinds of conditions, or if you're in the risk population, certainly you have to take those measures. But that's on an individual basis na. Kasi if you're going to rely on government to make these mandates, then, it's very difficult to tailor it to a specific situation. And there's a lot of collateral damage. There's a lot of restrictions. It affects our economy. It affects our tourism. So I think at this point, we've already given the vaccines to a lot of people. For the masks, I think the most important thing is know your risk and use the mask if you feel that your risk is higher than usual. And I think we'll be okay.
Mm-hmm. Lastly, before we let you go, Dr. X, where do you think the trend of COVID cases is going, at least until the end of the year?
Yeah, looking at it now, it seems to already be peaking. Eh? But, every time you relax restrictions, you expect that cases are going to go up talaga. Naturally, because people are not, people are more mobile, people are not using as many barriers to infection. But remember, the biggest thing here is whether those infections translate to hospitalizations, to severe disease. We don't lock down for the flu. We don't lock down for the common cold when there's a spike in cases. So it's really going towards that. There's no point in wringing our hands and saying, the cases increased by 31%, and yet there were no deaths, and less than 1% of those were severe cases. Of course, very important to keep an eye on it. But let's listen to the authorities. Let's listen to the legitimate experts. Pag sinabi ng DOH, we're okay. If DOH says, we have to be a little more careful, then let's listen to them. Let's not listen to other people who really don't know what they're doing.
Mm-hmm. All right. As always, thank you for your insights, Dr. Edson Salvanian. Stay safe, and thank you for always taking our call.
Okay, stay safe. Thank you very much.